Okay, you've heard of hip and knee replacements, but what about ankle replacements? That's why we welcome Dr. Brian Donnelly, from president of Community Hospitals and Family Health Centers.
Yes.
You're going to have to get one of those longer signs on your door, right?
Maybe.
Maybe, yes. Hey, so I've never even heard of ankle replacements before. I mean, where does this come from? Why would somebody need one?
So we've had a lot of success with hip and knee replacements, and it's a very common procedure. And so similar to the hip or the knee, the ankle also can get arthritis in it, where you get grinding of the two bones of the ankle rubbing against each other.
Ah.
And you can replace the surfaces of the ankle, just like you can replace the surfaces of the hip or the knee, with a new replacement.
What did they used to do before you could replace it?
Prior to this technology, the ankle replacement, an ankle fusion was actually very common, where you would take the two bones from the ankle and actually make them grow into one bone. You would lose motion with that, but have relief of the pain. And actually, in some cases, it's still a procedure that we use often for people.
So you lose that ability to go like this.
That's exactly right. You lose the up and down motion, but you keep the sideways motion.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so the hip, I remember that was really a difficult operation a long time ago. Now it gets simpler and simpler and simpler. Knee, same way. Where are we at with the ankle?
The ankle is probably 20 years behind in the evolution of the hip and knee, because it's a much newer technology. Actually, it's a little more complex joint, because there's a lot of different bones around there, mm-hmm. opposed to the hip and the knee. So we're improving, techniques are getting better and better, and actually the technology is much better. So it's an evolution of all of those components that have really brought this to the forefront and given a lot of relief to a lot of patients.
Mm-hmm. So this has nothing to do like with Achilles tendon or ligaments or that sort of thing. It's specific bones that go bad.
That's exactly right. This is actually the joint itself, which is the two bones rubbing against each other. So it doesn't affect the Achilles tendon or the other tendons of the ankle, and doesn't affect the ligaments either.
So how was it the first time you did this procedure? What was it like?
Well, it's always a thrilling procedure,
yeah,
to do. You put a lot of time and effort into developing the ankle replacement, and then to do the first one and see the benefit that you provide a patient is actually a really, really rewarding experience.
So what is the recuperation period and all that sort of thing? How can people respond to this?
So for about 6 weeks afterwards, people don't put weight on it. So use crutches or a walker. And actually nowadays, there's a scooter that is available so that people don't have to have so much demands on the upper extremity.
Is that the one on the knee?
That's exactly right.
I want to get one of those just for fun.
We'll bring one in here next time for you.
that's great. So you don't put any weight on it for some period of time.
Yes. And then after 6 weeks, you start doing some rehab and some therapy with it. And by 12 weeks, people are pretty functional, back to most activities at that point.
So the person out there at home right now doesn't feel like their ankle's right. What does it feel like when they should come see you right away?
I think the more activity you do, the more pain.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you're walking, you're trying to do activity, and the ankle is painful and hurting you, or you hear some grinding, that's probably a reasonable time to see your doctor to get an evaluation for your ankle and see if something can be done.
Can you wait too long?
You can't wait too long. I think it's important to know also, though, that a majority of people can be helped and their ankle can be made better without surgery.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of options available to make it better.
I'm doing okay, though. I think I'm okay.
Good.
Nice to see you again.
It's very nice to see you again. Thanks for your time.
We met each other a long time ago at the Greenbrier Hotel, right?
We were down there at an orthopedic conference, yes.
And I was going to go do some movie interviews with There's Something About Mary. Imagine the doctors being at the same thing, huh? there's some medical jokes in that movie, I think.
There may have been, yes.
It's good to see you again.
Thank you very much.
Okay, well, when we return, we're going to go behind the scenes of a big thriller out there. That's right. It's called Nonstop. It stars Liam Neeson and Julianne Moore. Who was the bad guy on that airplane?